We will use the funds to supplement our existing cash reserves to focus on three key work streams. One, the commercialization of our foundation Rafael gas and condensate project. This is the main game. We will complete select phase and get us FEED ready, progress gas and condensate sales and offtake agreements, and expedite our approvals for the project.
Hello and welcome back to the Proactive Studio. I'm Tylah Tully, and today I'm joined by Buru Energy CEO Thomas Nador, who's going to talk us through the new funding the company secured to support its activities, including drilling of the Rafael Shallow 1 oil exploration well. Thomas, thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Congratulations on your recent successful capital raise. Can you start by talking us through how the raise relates to the termination of your agreement with Sabre Energy for the Ungani and Rafael Shallow projects?
Yes, sure. Look, we deliberately didn't go into chapter and verse in our announcement. However, I'm happy to provide your viewers with a bit more color here. Perhaps I can start with Sabre. Sabre are a private company, and as such, we had to rely on their representations as to their funding capacity to meet their obligations under the agreements. This included third-party funding support, which they represented to us prior to Buru executing the agreements with them. Sabre are technically competent, and they had entered into several transactions with other E&P companies around the same time we entered the Ungani and Rafael Shallow transactions with Sabre. Ultimately, Sabre failed to raise the required funding within the timeframe that they had committed to under the farming agreements, and we had no choice but to walk away from both the Ungani and the Rafael Shallow transactions and quickly get after alternative funding options through a combination of farm-out transactions and a share placement.
So, can you tell us a bit more about this funding combination?
We had to move very quickly to fund Rafael Shallow due to the commitments already made in good faith to drill that well. These commitments were made on the back of the Rafael Shallow farming terms, which, as it turns out, were not able to be met by Sabre. As such, we executed binding agreements with two separate entities associated with our top shareholders to fund half of the cost of the Rafael Shallow well in exchange for a combined 25% interest in a commercial discovery. These agreements not only safeguard the drilling of Rafael Shallow as planned, but significantly reduce the size of the share placement by needing less funds to complete the well. As for the share placement, we were successful in introducing significant institutional investors to our register, which is a sign of confidence for Buru's forward strategy in developing the Rafael gas and condensate discovery. Through the process, we raised a total of $6.7 million via an oversubscribed placement. As it happens, we had interest well beyond this figure, so we had to scale back the placement to an optimum level linked to a firm use of funds. Due to the timing of the capital raise ahead of the drilling of Rafael Shallow this month, unfortunately, we were unable to undertake a share purchase plan as these can only be offered once every 12 months, with the previous one only undertaken in November last year.
So you've successfully raised the money now. Where are the funds going to be used?
We will use the funds to supplement our existing cash reserves to focus on three key work streams. One, the commercialization of our foundation Rafael gas and condensate project. This is the main game. We will complete select phase and get us FEED ready, progress gas and condensate sales and offtake agreements, and expedite our approvals for the project. Two, we will drill the Rafael Shallow oil prospect with spud targeted for mid-October. Just to remind your viewers, this prospect has the potential for resources in multiples of what the Ungani facility has produced inception to date. And number three, we will pull out all stops to continue and develop new potential Ungani crude sales pathways and prepare to restart production at the Ungani production facility.
It sounds like very busy times for the company. So what can investors look forward to in the near term?
Look, as far as near term is concerned, and the very near term is concerned, look out for the spudding of Rafael Shallow. We've commenced rigging up and are making preparations to commence drilling in October. This will be a relatively quick well, and potential exploration success will be material. Pardon me. We will also be keeping the market updated on the progress of our foundation Rafael gas and condensate development, as well as our work on restarting Ungani production and revenues. I do appreciate that these are challenging times for Buru, as well as the EMP business in general. However, I have every confidence that through hard work, resilience, and the support of our shareholders, Buru will perform.
Definitely sounds like very exciting times for Buru. Thomas, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me.